So, today, I thought we could do with a little bit attention. Sometimes I sort of get the urge to talk about certain feeling. I feel like I may feed a little bit off of your energy. One of these videos, so you can see I've got these really long finger claw jewelry things, and this purely for triggering ASMR. The clinky, scratchy metal sounds that they make. And also visuals as well. We needed to talk a little bit about self-belief, and manifesting a minute while you just listen to this scratching sound. Just think about something that is really important to you. Something that you always dreamed that you would have in your future. I'd suggest maybe not going really big, but simply thinking of something. Is physically attainable if you were to self-actualize it. So it might be getting a job promotion. It might be something really small and silly, like being able to do the splits. Maybe you always thought it'd be really cool to do the splits, and you always wanted to try, but just never gotten around to it. Maybe you've always wanted to take up dancing. Maybe you've always wanted to learn how to cook. Little things like that. Things that are achievable. And then I want you to just think, what are these steps I need to take in order to make these goals become a reality? Do you need to dedicate an hour out of your day? Trying and trying again with a specific skill? Do you need to wake up earlier in the morning? Do you need to make a phone call that you've been dreading, but maybe you know that it could potentially lead to something great? And I want you to think for a second why you haven't done those things. What is it that's been stopping you? Is it something physical? Like finding enough time in the day? Do you have some sort of commitment that is preventing you from self-actualization? Is it your own anxiety? What is it that's stopping me from taking on this incredible thing that I've always dreamt of? I can almost always guarantee that there is an element of self-doubt. An element of you almost something in your way a little bit, even if you're adamant that it's not you that's the problem, it's just, you know, just life, and life gets in the way and we all don't get what we want. But sometimes when it comes to that, if you just made a little bit of time spare, 5 minutes even, then maybe you would be able to achieve one of those goals that you set for yourself. It's always good to question ourselves on keeping ourselves accountable. Questioning our intentions, how much we want things. And then it's a really good way to kind of check in and see, you know, what we really want. What things have become more important to us recently, and then what things have become less important, and then we can sort of flip those over depending on what is more important for us now. It's really important though to know that doing your best. We don't want to ever doubt ourselves. We never want to think that we're not capable of anything, because as human beings, we're capable of so many great things. But it's important to recognize when we're spreading ourselves too thin. We simply cannot achieve amazingly great things when we're trying to achieve our 200 insanely incredible things all at once. We've got to sort of do it bit by bit. You know, maybe apart from your day-to-day life, you maybe focus on two small goals at a time. So say that's learning to do the splits, and maybe becoming a reader. So these are two things you feel will give you a greater sense of purpose, discipline, make you feel like you can accomplish things, maybe nourish you in terms of your physical health or your mental health. Maybe the books make you feel wiser. Maybe both of those things are a real time for self-care. So you know that these two small goals are gonna really add to your day-to-day life. Now, it may take time to get into a routine. Maybe you don't add these things in your everyday routine. Maybe you just add them once a week. Maybe that's all you can fit in. Maybe you do 5 minutes of stretching every night before you go to bed. And then you read for 1 hour a week on a Saturday afternoon when you get a little bit of free time. Of course, maybe you always imagined that you would be an avid reader who reads every single day, can get through a book a week. But sometimes we have to be honest with ourselves, hold ourselves accountable, and say, it's okay that I can't fully dedicate myself to this one thing. Instead, I'm going to do the best I can in order to make myself happy. And find that little bit of time to make those goals a reality. Even if that goal of reading a full book, maybe it takes you 3 months just to be able to read a book. To read it just a little bit every week, almost like watching 10 minutes of a film every week. Eventually you'll see the whole story. It's good to still strive for things, even when we feel like we simply can't fit them in. You're just honest with yourself and you find a little nugget of time for self-care to make yourself feel self-improved, like you've achieved, even if it's silly little things that to other people mean nothing. If it means a lot to you, then it's important. Accountable. Keep achieving little by little. In terms of goals that maybe we can't work towards ourselves, maybe we have to wait for the opportunity to come our way. There are ways that we can manifest to give ourselves the best possible chance of achieving these things. So, for example, you send out positive energy into the world and then you get positive energy back. So, making sure that you are always kind to other people. You take the time to work hard and always choose to do the right thing. When it comes to things related to what you want to manifest, you always approach them with said goal in mind, so that you are always striving towards that certain ideal. So, for example, I wanted to, if I wanted to be offered an audition for a job, for an acting job, then in order to manifest that, I would keep applying for auditions, obviously, but I would also keep my acting profile very up to date. I would continue to practice any of my skills, special skills. I would practice accents. I would always try and challenge myself to try new monologues and new scripts, act to camera and then watch myself back and critique myself. I would also actively support others who receive opportunities like that, and send overall positive energy towards the universe regarding acting. And then I am setting myself up for creating the ideal scenario. So that if I were to successfully manifest this idea of the acting audition, I would be in the best possible place to make it happen and also make it successful when it does come my way as well. I hope that makes sense. Manifestation can be really powerful. It's all about a state of mind and making sure that you're open to saying yes. Making sure that you are always thinking about what else you can do to send positive energy to others. What else you can do to keep yourself on the ball and ready for when the opportunity comes. And making sure you're sound of mind as well. Always looking after your mental health and making sure that you are ready for any anxiety or self-doubt that may come along when an opportunity arises that you've been waiting for. If you're prepared, then usually things go well. And finally, I just want to talk about self-doubt. We're always so critical of ourselves. We tend to immediately think that we're not capable of something that we've never done before. Just because we've never seen our minds be capable. Bodies be capable, even though we can see other humans achieving what we want to achieve, we always tend to tell ourselves, but I can't do that. And I'm here to tell you why. Why can't you do that? I promise you, the world is not against you. Sometimes it may feel that way, but you are capable of improving. You are capable of receiving opportunities. You just have to believe in yourself that you are worthy of putting the effort in. A lot of the time, it's not really believing that you are worthy of the opportunity itself. But people don't even get through the front door usually of making things happen because they don't believe that they're even capable of working towards something. So they never even start. Like, for example, say I wanted to run a marathon. I don't believe that I would even be able to run a 5k, so I'm not even going to try and start running. Well then, you've not achieved anything. Yes, the ultimate goal might be to run a marathon, but if you don't even start trying that 5k, then you're never going to get up to the top goal. And you should always celebrate those little achievements on the ladder up. as well. Think of how big an achievement that 5K is for somebody that's never run before. Sometimes it's great to think big, but you have to think big with all the little steps in between. You can't just wake up one morning and go, yes, I'm going to run a marathon today, and do it. You have to start small and work your way up. Nobody was born with the skills that they have today. Everyone has had to work towards them. Yes, of course, people have the natural talent for things, like people have the natural talent for singing. But I can almost guarantee that most people who sing as a career will have had singing coaches. They would have gone to singing lessons. They would have practiced and practiced and practiced. So it's really important to understand that just because you've not woken up with a skill, just because you're not naturally gifted at something, doesn't mean that you will never be able to achieve it. So self-doubt. Stop believing that you are not capable of things. Start looking at yourself in the mirror every morning, telling yourself, I am wonderful, I am capable, and I am proud of everything that I achieve. I want you to spend every conscious moment thinking about how you can manifest your small goals to make yourself feel more developed. And self-actualize. Being capable of great things. Okay. So, I'm gonna leave this video here. I hope some of what I've said has been somewhat helpful. Morning and believe that you can, that you will. It may take 2 months, 2 years, 20 years, but if you truly want something, then don't let anything stand in your way. If you like these as a trigger, let me know, and I can use them again. Okay. So with that,